Hey, Richie here from RW Hobbies. Welcome back for my March bench update. It's been a month since my last one and really busy as always. Not only modeling, work, kids, life in general, tons of stuff. I'm exhausted, so I'm looking forward to a nice relaxing weekend. So two finished builds, work in progress, some purchases, look around the Facebook group, the usual spiel. So yeah, let's start with back to the beginning of the month, and it was the Old Dominion IPMS show here in Richmond, Virginia. If you're an organizer and you're watching this, I apologize, but I don't hold back. I am brutally honest, and it was a big disappointment. Not talking about the models or people's stuff on display, but the trade area. So, well, let's take a step back. So it was on Saturday morning and I had my kids that weekend, and I was planning originally of taking some of my stuff and putting in a competition, some recent stuff, display it there. But then when I realized I had my kids that weekend, it was just too much. I couldn't, my two daughters, I mean, trying walking in, carrying like fragile aircraft kits and stuff, it was gonna be too much. So I left that behind and we just went and caught, look at a few models and look at the trade area really. So. Opened at 8:30, I think, and we got there about 9 o'clock because I get it early because all the good stuff goes, gets sold. So got there early, walked around, and it's just same as, I think, I can't remember if it was last year or the year before. I know 1 year we skipped because of the pandemic, but it was just a few, I've been a few of these now, and it's just a big disappointment in terms of like, a lot of stuff is just crap, basically. It's like 80s, 90s monogram kits, old stuff, which is a terrible kit, not much modern stuff. And the one or two people who are selling modern stuff, the prices are so high. I can just order them online from my usual like online retailer with shipping, and they're getting like still 10, 20% cheaper than what they're selling at a trade show or a, you know, model show. So that was a disappointment. Everything just seemed so dated out there. Just again, seemed like old stuff people didn't want. There was very few sundries. There's only one, in the whole trade show, I think there's only one person selling paint. And that was just like some kind of acrylic paint. I can't remember if it was like MIG ammo or like Vallejo or something. There wasn't one person selling lacquer paint, which is a big disappointment. So I really, one thing I really wanted was a tin of gold paint to help tinting my canopy for my Raptor. Lacquer gold paint to mix with my Alclad, but that never happened. So the only thing is there's one guy in the corner selling some stuff. I think it was maybe some part built stuff, but he has some of those like Kitty Hawk, like Pave Hawk and the Black Hawk range of helicopters. He was selling a few for about, I think about $65, $75, which is a really good price because they were about $100, $125 brand new before Kitty Hawk went out of business. So one thing I did notice, I was very tempted to buy, he had the 24 scale Airfix Hawker Typhoon. It looked good. I didn't open the box, but it looked like maybe it was brand new, hasn't been started, and it was he had it $75. And now they go for about $125. So that was a really good price. I did go back a couple of times to look at it, but in the end I was like, this thing's big. I have no room for anything. I'm not gonna build it anytime soon just to save my money. So I didn't buy anything at all in the whole show. Trying to think, no, nothing. It's just, and the worry for me is like, if you're new to modeling and you go to these shows, you see it like listed on online on newspaper, whatever, and you go by and you think, oh, pick up some of these paints, you pick up some like acrylic paints and you're picking up an 80s monogram kit, go home and try to build that thing, you don't get a very good experience because the pigs are put together, the kit, the paints are hard to work with, so it's not the modern day stuff, you don't get a true representation of the hobby, and it's gonna turn a lot of people off. So that was my main thing. In terms of the actual display area, again, we got there early, so a lot of stuff wasn't there, but there was some cool stuff. I'll put a couple of pictures up. I took about two pictures of things that kind of caught my eye. First one was the figure, which was painted really well. Looked really cool. And again, there wasn't much stuff there at that time in the morning. And then I saw that nice dial, armor dial, which I'll add pictured right now too. And I can't remember if I took a picture of it or not. If I did, I'll add it. There was a 16th scale Classy Hobby Stuart tank, I think it was, which I've built. Like a little dial, 16th scale dial was really cool too. I think that was a group from Virginia Beach, and they were talking about setting up some kind of like armor only kind of model show kind of stuff in Virginia Beach, I think, but I might be totally wrong. But yeah, that was it. So a little bit of a disappointment in the modeling show. I don't think I'll go there again, to be honest with you, next year. It's just, there's nothing there good there. I mean, one thing I wanted, which I'll show, which I do have now, was I wanted the Great Wall Hobbies F15 to build the 48 scale, and I was hoping you could pick one up there too. And there was nowhere in the whole place was there any Great Wall Hobby stuff for sale. I looked pretty good and did nothing. So again, that's a bit of a disappointment. So it's nothing really for me. A lot of car stuff. So if you're into cars, maybe like your Tamiya cars or AMT and that kind of stuff, it's probably for you. But for an aircraft guy, just a little bit slim picking some modern stuff. I don't really want to build like 80s kits anymore. So that was that. And then moving along, building wise, as you know, I've got the F22 and I've knocked that one out and built it. I've done mini build series of 5 parts. I've just finished filming that before I started this morning. So part 4, which would be the weathering, will go up next week, I think. And in a couple of weeks time, I'll put up the final part, the final reveal. But she turned out really good. So a couple of things on here, which I'll point out, which I made mistakes on, because again, brand new kit. The whole purpose of me doing this was kind of show everybody how well it goes together and pick any kind of issues I found. And with the kit itself, there were no real issues, but on my end, I messed up because I did put the intakes on before I put the fuselage halves together. So you'll put the intakes on, follow the instructions, basically you'd be okay. So put the intakes on, then sandwich the fuselage halves together. I didn't do that, I had some fit issues. And the second thing was I left the gear off till the end, like I always do, and I just couldn't get it on at the very end. It was, you have to do it during the build per the instructions. Spoiler alert. So following instructions should be fine, but the gear has to go in, the main gear for sure. It's just too tight and there's too much connections. It just doesn't fit, so I had to kind of hack at it to get it in there. But I got it in the end and it turned out okay. The main thing for me was learning the paints. So the HobbyBoss callouts were fine for the paints. Mixing the super metallics with the grays worked really good. Used no clear coats. I will show you this in a minute. Used no clear coats so you can still get that luster and that sheen light. And the main thing for me was the canopy. I think I kind of nailed the metallic tinting. And how I did that was, I'm trying to think, Alclad, again, watch part 4 and I'll go through it. But basically Alclad transparent yellow mixed with small part of metallic paint and you got that sheen. So let me kind of pull her in and kind of show you where we're at with this one. And obviously it's finished. And there she is, really happy how it turned out. And you see that canopy as well in the light, how it's shining, and it is see-through still. And you can see my finger through there. It's kind of hard to hold it, but there she is. Really happy how it turned out. Part 3, obviously, we just got the block colors down. 4, we kind of added some post-shading. And again, in the light there, you can see it sheen, canopy coming off. And the underside, see, we do have a gear on, the weapons bays and stuff. And really happy with this one. It's not my usual kind of genre, but I think I kind of nailed the colors on this one. I'm very happy how it turned out. So yeah, there she is, the I Love Kit 48 scale Raptor. Now, a lot of discussion, when I did a review, I mentioned it was £100 from the UK, which is $150. These are showing up now in the US at $100. So scale hobbyist, $99.99 for this kit, which just seems to be like $100, seems to be about going rate right now for a 48 scale fighter jet, unfortunately. Okay, but the canopy's not gonna sit on right, I'll fix it later, but there you go, basically propped on top there. But you see canopy color again, you can see through it, and it has that metallic sheen. The only thing is, I did, again, as I mentioned, I couldn't get gold paint. I have brass in my stash, so I had a dot of brass, so gold would be a slightly different color, but nevertheless happy. So there she is, that's the F22. So that one's finished. I'm kind of glad it's finished too, to be honest with you. It's just, again, not my usual kind of jam. I like things a little slightly bit older, like 90s rather than straight modern stuff. All right, let me put it down so I don't break it. Next up is this little lady, which I really enjoyed doing, was the Arctic Camo A10. If you're on my Facebook group, you'd have seen these pictures already. And there she is. I'm using the aero masks like I did with the Raptor. Makes life so much easier. And just really loved how this one turned out in the end. Really cool kit, probably not a realistic loadout, but A10 just went crazy and loaded it out. So this is a 1982 scheme from a operation. It was kind of experimental Arctic camo from a 1982 exercise up in Alaska somewhere, I think it was, or Canada maybe, I don't remember. All right, so there she is. So again, this is finished again, really happy how this one turned out. Now, the thing to note with this one was the nose weight. It says no nose weight on this. I added 1 ounce, which is what, 28 grams, I think it is. And it's just right on the limits. If I take the canopy off, canopy weighs nothing. If I take the canopy off, it tail sits. So that tiny little bit of weight on the canopy just keeps it level. So if you're going to build this one, you want to probably add like 2 ounces or like 50 grams just to be sure, because especially if you add a bunch of like ordnance like I did, but still it's it does tilt back a little bit without the canopy, and the canopy doesn't weigh anything. So just shows you right on the limits there. But again, beautiful kit and number one finish, number 48 scale kit as well. So let me kind of put this one down so I don't break that. And then finally, in progress. So I started this a few weeks back before everything kicked off in the world, but it's the Russian Ural 4320 truck by Zvezda. And my plan was this was going to do a little diorama, not a military vehicle, do it as a civilian, but I've got a couple of like female figures. I was going to do like a little kind of vignette, not a diorama, like broken out side of the road kind of truck. So I think I filmed a little bit of this one too. So let's go and cut that one in and you can see my progress on the Euro truck. All right, so taking a break from the aircraft and doing this Ural 4320 truck from Zvezda. Now, this really nice kit. It's really well detailed. Unfortunately, a lot of stuff you're not going to see. So it's this kit right here. And I'm thinking of doing maybe like a post-apocalyptic kind of thing. But here's kind of the where I'm at so far on the chassis. And just see all those axles and all that stuff on there. Just that detail. That's a day's work getting, you know, all that stuff on there. There's plenty more still to go, but unfortunately I think a lot of this is going to be buried underneath the bed. But again, just look, I like how well detailed that is. It fits perfectly, no problem at all. Again, on the other side, all the axles and they all slot in, and yeah. Engine block, still more stuff to go on here, but once it's all painted up, it's going to look pretty awesome, I think. Again, the detail, very, very nice. Can rival any 24th or 5th scale car, I think. All kinds of belts and stuff and other parts go on the engine, we'll paint separately. So that's what we're at. This one, if you remember back when I did a bench update, it showed us I got a couple of figures off AliExpress, and I built the figures. So again, obviously new painting up. So I got a girl here who's going to be sitting probably in a cab. Well, she will be sitting in a cab, and then the other girl here will be standing outside the truck with the gas can. Again, I might go do like a little bit of apocalyptic, post-apocalyptic kind of dio base kind of thing, I think. But again, not sure how well you can see those guys, but these will be painted up. Just we had to get it primed and hand-painted. And then, yeah, I just want to show you this chassis again. It's just amazing detail on this. Very nice kit indeed. So I'm going to go ahead and carry on building all this stuff. Fortunately, all this stuff is the same color, so it's going to get painted at the same time in black. So, yeah, I'll check back in later when I've got some more updates. All right, so since then, we've got the back on. Basically, all the pieces I've got in the back, it's kind of handy having a truck. You can hold all the piece I'm working on in the bed right here. So let me take the cab out. And that's where she looks. Beautifully fitting kit, nicely detailed. Again, you see the engine and the bed there. And I've gone with the like a pastel kind of blue. I think that's using, ironically, a Luftwaffe color, which is Guns 323, which is like a light blue. But I just wanted light blue, so I can do the cab that same color as well. So there we go, we've got the bed, truck bed on, it's not even glued, it just clicks into place. Got the engine detail done, and again, 35th scale. And I started with the cab, so just literally with my Posca pen, white Posca pen, picked out the dials. Now the one problem with this kit is, there's no instrument, there's no decals for instruments, it's just plain, so it's kind of a bit of a bummer. So you can buy like a Yahoo instrument panel and aftermarket stuff, but I used my pen, just basically just drew, you know, the white dials on. Painted green and black, and got various other parts. Now it's really just building this cab up, then the cab will just fit on the front, and we can get moving on with some weathering and stuff on this. So really great kit. Again, it goes together really well. This is the best, the 4320 Euro truck. Very nice indeed. So that's it. So that's my work in progress. That is my, or are my builds. Now what have I purchased or received? So first of all, got some more stickers. So shout out, thank you firstly, Dan from Dan Cave. Got his little sticker right here. Again, like I mentioned, once I'm moving, at some point this year I'm moving, and once I get my new studio set up, I'm creating, I'll put these stickers on display, and there will be a plain wall, there'll be more stuff going on in the background. Then Mr. Breckland sent me a Paul ISM sticker. I've got a international scale model sticker, and I've got a ultimate modding product sticker. So again, these will go prime in place of my other stickers. I've got one from Hugo's Hobby Bench, and I've got a couple others too. So again, if you want to send me any stickers, feel free to do so. And I'll be up on some point this year, it'll be up displayed somewhere in my background. So one of my camera shots, you'll see your stickers displayed. Hype, a lot of people bought these recently. These aren't very expensive. I got mine from eBay. I think it was about $10. It's a Tihu, T-I-H-H-O, this guy. And if you don't know what it is, it's a desk vacuum. So it's basically a battery. I think it's like one or two AAA batteries, AA batteries. And basically, it's a vacuum cleaner for your desk. And you just unscrew it, tip it out. And it actually works pretty good. Picks up all the dust. I've got a really messy bench right now. Once I get this truck finished, I'm going to take all this out, deep clean it, and get ready before I start my next build. But it's basically a little kind of desk vacuum, and just run it over all your area. It sucks all the dust, all the little pieces. It actually works really good. So a lot of people bought these recently, and I jumped on the bandwagon and got one too. So Tihu. I think they're on Amazon, but they were cheaper on eBay. So again, like $10. And the Chinese, but the seller was in the US. So I got it within, you know, a few days. Kits. So, following on from talking about Bretland, let's talk Paul Bretland, let's go again. I watched one of his live streams earlier this week, and he was thinking about his next build, and he was looking at the Toyota LFA. Now, this is a kit I had in my stash before. I sold it because I promised I'd never do cars again, but he, with some other people, was like sharing a screen, looking at some colors of these guys. Now, the white looks really cool, but they came across a baby blue one, which looked amazing. So I did some research, and it's one of a kind, I think, in China. They only built 500 of these, but one in China, they painted this baby blue, and it's actually a Lamborghini color. I think it's Tiffany blue, something or other, definitely Tiffany blue, Lamborghini color, you can find it. Gravity Color Spain have it. And it's a really baby blue, it looks amazing in this car. So firstly, I love this car. It's a really nice looking car, and baby blue just looks spectacular. So I don't know if I'm going to build it. I might send it to somebody as a commission, have them build it for me. But we'll see. So it's a beautiful kit. I'll do a review of it. It's been around for a while, but most places are sold out. It's hard to find. You can get them in Japan to send across. But I went on Amazon and found a third-party marketplace had these for reasonable price, like retail price, so about $59. And they have one in stock, or a couple in stock. So I got it for Amazon Prime. 2 days later, I had it at my doorstep. So got this guy, again, just a beautiful car. I think $375,000, I think they cost brand new, which I know Lexus made a huge loss on each one because it's, I think it was like a test bed for them where they really wanted to test their technology and see what they could produce. So they did produce this a few years back, but it's just, yeah, really nice car. So I know I'll never do a car kit. I'm not sure if I will do it again. I might just get the right color and then have somebody else build it for me because you can't buy a die cast of this, and especially that baby blue color. It looks spectacular, like I mentioned. So that's the Toyota LFA. All right. F15. Everybody's been a lot of F15s right now for the Gary Pashley Memorial build, group build going on. I didn't want to do a 72nd scale one. I built the 48 scale E version for before the channel a few years ago, and I'm really happy with it. But I built it in flight on the stand, all closed up. And this has so much detail. It has full detail engines, avionics bays, all kinds of stuff. And it's a shame to kind of close it up. So this time I'm just want it opened up. And the reason I bought this in particular was I noticed two Bobs have literally next week are releasing a brand new decal set. And it's for the Grim Reapers, and it's just a really cool looking, like black tails, a coffin on the speed brake, really cool decal set. So I bought this based upon decals, kind of like we did the A10 really. If I see some decals I like, I'd totally buy a kit, because it's just based upon that. So F15C, great kit. This review will go up in a couple of weeks. Been out a few years now, this kit, but this is Great Wall Hobbies 48 scale, and a very nice kit indeed. C, so it's a two-tone camo, not the all dark gray like the E version. And single seater as well. So it's that guy. And finally, this guy, ooh, this box is really heavy. You know, same color scheme, but it's about 10 years apart in terms of kit release. Same font color scheme, but this one is the SU27, new kit out this year. This here it says the first edition, so I got a Metapedo tube. But Great Wall Hobbies, once again, 48 scale SU27, and it's really nice kit. Ton, this thing's jam-packed full of plastic. Great detail. And if you want to save some little money, I got mine on eBay from China. These go for about, about $100, $100 plus shipping in the US. I got this for about $80, $85 from eBay shipped from China, and it came airmail, not ocean freight. So the estimate was about mid-May, But obviously, I got like 2 months earlier. It came to about 3 weeks. So 3 weeks to arrive, which is not bad at all from China. And I saved myself $20. And it's, again, the SU-27, great kit. Lots of markings in this one too. There's 5 markings. You got some Russian, you got Ukrainian, and you have a couple of Chinese markings in here too. My plan with this one would be the Ukrainian digi camo, the blues and stuff, which I'm sure you guys have seen many times before. So that's my third big purchase. And that, thinking about it. Oh, no, that's not it. Also, I got myself restock and I got all my missing colors of Tamiya LP, the metallic paints. These are really easy to spray, really nice paints. So I had a few holes, so I picked out like metallic black. I didn't have light gunmetal, that's just a resupply. Gloss aluminum. Tons of colors here. I've got every single metallic one now, I think. LP11 silver. This is my go. I use this a lot. I got a few of these LP11s. Flat aluminum LP38. This one. This is metallic gray LP61. That's like a nice kind of color too. And got a couple LP5s, which is like really nice semi-gloss black. And this one's another gunmetal LP19. So just, you see, this is really nice metallic paint, spray really easily, and it's always good. Some of my supply issues with getting these, so I got a few of each just to kind of stock up, and it's always nice to have a lot of metallic colors of different sheens and stuff, different brands and different types. I really like the super metallics I used on the F-22, and adding these two gives me a lot of options as well. So, not very expensive, I think a couple, about 250 a jar or whatever, and obviously thin these 50-50 at least. And that is my purchases. So let me, as always, switch to my Facebook group. Let's take a quick look around a few people's work, and we'll come right back. All right, so here we go. Again, a quick roundup of the Facebook group. And as always, the link is in the show notes below. It's Facebook, so it's free. It doesn't cost you anything to join or anything like that. And some great work in here. So a few I picked out. The first one is Parpers Hasegawa 48th scale F-15C. Just a cool looking aircraft, but he's done a really great job. You notice here all the panels are slightly different shaded, different colors. You got the modeling going on. Just a really interesting and well presented aircraft build. There you go, look, awesome looking jet. And yeah, very nicely done indeed. And looks like he's using the Coastal Designs base, which I have a few of these in 72nd scale. And they really do help set the aircraft off when you take your pictures and display them. Again, beautiful aircraft. Next up is Jake, and not only is this a great looking aircraft, but it's his first attempt at scale modeling, and pretty cool. Like, you certainly have natural ability here, and my first 20 aircraft looked like a dog's dinner, so this looks fantastic. All the decals are down good, it's painted nicely. Great start. So, again, I can't believe this is your first ever attempt. All painted nicely, masked off, decals down, and a really nice looking Super Hornet. I don't think I've ever done a Jolly Rogers before, so maybe one day I might build one. But great, great job for the first attempt. And welcome to the channel and to the Facebook group. Mark's up next. Did pick this one because the Colombian markings, you don't see many Colombian aircraft in scale modeling, and this is the AMK's 48th scale kit. AMK do some really nice kits. The MiG-31 is definitely up there as one of the best 48 scale kits I've ever built. I do have the F-14 in my stash as well, I think somewhere. So again, here it is. Looking really nice, clean build, nicely done, interesting camo. Again, very cleanly done, nice modeling, and looking really cool and an unusual subject. You don't see many Kafirs or Colombian aircraft, as I mentioned. All right, next up is Paul's 12 scale Italieri Alfa Romeo 8C2300 Monza. This caught my eye a few times. It's been around a few years, I think, this kit, but it's kind of highly priced now. It's very expensive, but I think it might take a little bit of work, but it just turns out a really kind of classic motorsport subject in a really nice size, 12 scale. So this is not going to be tiny. It's going to be a decent size. And you can see here the detail here, all the wiring, all of the engine. Really nice build and a really nice subject. And going for the pictures here, this one here I noticed as well, again, the engine detail looking really nice, nicely painted and nicely engineered kit, I guess. Last up, Robert and his flanker.
these aircraft are huge. I built a few 30-second scale aircraft, but mostly like Harrier and the F-16, they're pretty compact aircraft. But when you look at the size of this compared to him here, it's massive. I mean, look at, this is the same scale. So you can see how things have evolved in the last 80 years from a Spitfire 30-second scale to a 30-second scale flanker nowadays. They're just massive. And you see the size of the person. It's always nice to see a figure next to a model just to get an idea of scale, how big these things really are, and the amount of power these engines must have to get this thing in the air. And yeah, very impressive engineering here in this aircraft. But just the kit is massive. It's got to be at least 2.5 foot long. Definitely something I'd like to build in the future as well. I just mentioned I got the 48th scale one, which is big enough as it is, but in 32nd it's going to be massive, as you can see. And that's a Spitfire, which isn't small by any means in 32nd scale. But that's it. That wraps up the Facebook group. Just a few quick zip around. Full disclosure, somehow my screen capturing hasn't been working, so this is the fifth time I have to record this, so it might be a little bit fast-paced, but I apologize for this. But again, yeah, I had a lot of troubles technology today getting this uploaded into the video. But thank you as always for sharing your work for everybody. And back to me.
So there we go. That's it. Thank you as always for posting. I appreciate everybody putting their work in my page there and sharing and asking questions and building the group up. It's really kind of really happy how it's turned out. Something new we started this year. So thank you as always for watching. Appreciate the support. I've had a lot of new Patreons and channel members recently, so thumbs up, thank you. It helps me keep the lights on, buy new kits, do new videos, and support the channel. So really appreciate that as well. And finally, that is it. So thank you as always for watching. I'll be back in a month for my next update, and I'll catch you later. Bye.